Mady and the Cupid Killer by Farida Abdel Aziz. Part 6. As the sun came up, painting the sky purple, the other police officers had already blocked the street, preventing the endless flow of reporters to enter the crime scene. Mady was sitting on the sidewalk with a cup of coffee.
She has a broken arm, but she'll be fine. Maria Sullivan's her name,
said Callahan, pointing at the woman.
He had a diamond pin in his pocket to put on after he... We identified him as Adamo Kirsch. The clothes belonged to his mother, who was killed at the age of 23. That's why they were all 23 days apart. She worked in the same fashion house as the others. It was an accident at work and no one lifted a finger, apparently. She was a nobody and the whole thing was swept under the rug. Fucking psycho, though. You did well, kiddo. I'll write the report. Now go home and get rest. You deserve it. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'll be fine. Just tired.
Mady was unable to meet Callahan's eyes as he nodded, hugging his coffee. That was a lie. He did have something on his mind, but it was something he could not share with his partner. Or anyone, for that matter. He couldn't hide the fact that he could relate to Adamo Kirsch. He, too, spent his life looking for vengeance, looking for the man who killed his father, like Adamo spent his life avenging his mother. The only difference is that Mady hid his obsession under the shadow of his shining badge of law and justice, while Adamo sacrificed innocent women, unable to find the culprit. But he could not mouth the similarities between their motives. He could only keep it a burning secret, hoping it would only drive him to do good, now that he saw the bad vein in himself.